Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty God, who command us to prepare the way for Christ the Lord, grant in your kindness, we pray, that no infirmity may weary us as we long for the comforting presence of our heavenly physician, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
To whom a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, to whom can you liken me as an equal? Says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high, and see who has created these things. He leads out their army and numbers them, calling them all by name. By his great might and the strength of his power, not one of them is missing. Why, O Jacob, do you say, and declare, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Do you not know, or have you not heard? The Lord is eternal God, creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint nor grow weary, and his knowledge is beyond scrutiny. He gives strength to the fainting. For weak, he makes vigor abound. Through young men faint and grow weary, and youths stagger and fall. They that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on as with eagle's wings. They will run and not grow weary, walk and not grow faint. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite according to our crimes.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Behold, the Lord comes to save his people. Blessed are those prepared to meet him.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the crowds, "Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light." The Gospel of the Lord. I love the readings of today, that from Prophet Isaiah, to begin with, "To whom can you liken me as an equal?" says the Holy One. "Lift up your eyes on high and see who has created these things." Lift up your eyes on high and see who's created these things. He leads out their army and numbers them, calling them all by name. By his great might and the strength of his power, not one of them is missing. We've got this God who loves us so much. He loves us. Why do we come to church? What's our purpose for coming to church? Yes. To pray. And what is prayer? What's prayer all about? Yes.
It's about Jesus.
It's about Jesus. We come to church because it's about Jesus and we pray. Why else? We come to church, we pray, and prayer is when we, yes. Do we come to church because we celebrate? Every time we come to church, that's a good one. Every time we come to church, we celebrate the birth of Jesus because we celebrate his presence in the Holy Eucharist. You know, Jesus, he was laid in a manger. What's that manger represent? What was the manger used for back in the days of Jesus? What was its purpose? Yes. It was to feed the animals. It was the food trough. And Jesus was laid in a food trough as a reminder, he's come to feed us, God's creation. And so we come to recognize Jesus, we come to pray. But what is the main purpose for coming to church? The main purpose. All those things are reasons why we come, but what's the main purpose? What's that? We come and we learn about God, but what's our main purpose? There's one ultimate purpose. The only thing we should be coming to church for, we do all those things while we're here. Yes. We come to receive the Eucharist. To love God. We're going to come back to, yes. To love God, to thank him, to praise him. Simple as that. We come to church solely to just love him, recognize him, and to praise him. And when we come, God loves us so much that he still gives back to us. But our only purpose for coming should be to love him, to praise him, to worship him. And that's why it's so important to be here on Sundays or Saturday night when we celebrate Sunday Mass, because it's when the entire parish community comes to worship and praise God together. And when we come and worship and praise, and because we're not here by ourselves, we're with God. And I love here, in this first reading, as I shared with you, it says, to whom can you liken me as an equal, says the Holy One. Lift up your eyes on high and see who has created all these things. Here's what I was thinking about. Lift your eyes up on high. Here we have the planet Earth. Look at that. Think about it. And look at those other planets, Venus and Mars and Mercury and Pluto. Earth is the largest, right? And just think, God created all these planets, and he put us on the planet Earth. But I was looking at this. And right there, Earth is the largest planet up there, isn't it? Earth is the largest planet. It overpowers those other ones. You know, why didn't he go to Pluto or Mercury or Mars or Venus? Yes. It's because it wouldn't fit all of us, but I was thinking about this. Look at these planets. There's Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and look at Earth. See how small Earth is? See the difference in size? Earth is just a real little place compared to Jupiter and Saturn. And I was thinking about this. God came down to this real little planet, Earth. An insignificant planet compared to these other larger ones. But then, look at this. There's the sun. Look at the Earth. See the little arrow pointing down to the Earth? See how small the Earth is? Now, this is in our galaxy. But you know that in other galaxies, beyond our galaxy, there are planets even larger than the sun? And I'm just thinking this morning about it, that God, that's why it says, lift up your eyes on high and see who has created all these things. God loves us so much that he came to this real little planet to be with us. Isn't that a reason to worship and to praise him? Because despite the rest of the universe, he comes to us. He comes to us. And then we hear in that gospel reading, Jesus said to the crowds, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, my burden is light. God loves us so much, he not only comes to us, he says, now we come to him. And all the difficulties that we have in life, he takes them away from us. And I was thinking about this one. We're getting ready. You've been to confession already for the Advent season, but you can still always go back. We're getting ready for our penance service, our confessions tonight for the whole parish community. And I was thinking about some sins that we commit in our lives. And I was thinking about that one sin that oftentimes I think we all commit at some point or another. And that's that sin of lying, of not being truthful. When you lie, when you're not truthful, what do you have to then worry about? What do you have to worry about when you lie, when you're not truthful? What do you worry about? Yes. You worry about the sins that you committed, but what's the one big thing you begin to worry about when you told a lie to somebody? That you're going to get caught. So now you're worried, I'm going to get caught. Well, now, you lie about something. Let's say somebody broke something. And somebody wants to know, who broke this? And you're the one who broke it. It's not me, I didn't do it. But you're the one who broke it. Well, they say, well, where were you when this happened? Well, even though you were right in the room where it got broken, you now got to think about, okay, where was I? Let's say it was broken in the classroom. Well, I was over in the lunchroom at that time. So now you had to create a whole nother lie and to say you were someplace else. But then somebody says, well, I was in the lunchroom, I didn't see you there. Well, no, I was in the bathroom in the lunchroom. Well, so-and-so was in the bathroom lunchroom. Well, no, I was actually out on the playground, I didn't know you at that time. So you begin to have to create all these other lies, then you got to worry about who you said what to. And the gospel says this. So now you've got this big burden of making sure you always tell the truth. And who did you say what story to? But Jesus says, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. He basically says, just tell the truth. If you just follow the commandments, if you just do what I ask of you, life is so much easier. Just be nice to people. Just help each other out. Admit the fact that sometimes you make mistakes. Be truthful, be honest, and you don't have a burden. And just come then and worship me and celebrate me and love me. Recognizing our dependence on God's mercy, we place our petitions before Him as we turn to Him with our prayers.
For the church, the people of God, that our journey together this Advent will lead each of us to a deeper love of Jesus, our Redeemer, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, that our leaders will place good of its citizens before any political considerations or lobbyist support, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For innocent victims of war or terrorism, may they find safe shelter in the welcome embrace of good people who come to their aid, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children and youth of our parish, that Advent programs will lead them to a greater knowledge and a deeper appreciation of the incarnation of Jesus Christ, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful who have died, may they rest in the beauty of heaven and join in the chorus of angels proclaiming the glory of God, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those listed in our parish book of intentions and for those who we offer our masses, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. You know that there's many people in the world who have very little food, and some people really have no food to eat. And so often we kind of waste food. We don't eat what's given to us. I've been down at the lunchroom, and I've seen some of your lunches thrown in the trash. I've seen that your food's not finished on your plates. And a lot of people don't have anything to eat. And Pope Francis is asking us all to do all that we can to help rid the world of hunger. And one of the things you can do is not waste food. Be thankful for the food you have. So let us also pray this morning for all of those who are dying of hunger, who have nothing to eat, that we may become more mindful of the blessings God gives to us through the nourishment that He gives us. We pray to the Lord. Almighty God, we come to you with faith and hope, confident that you will hear our prayers, and we ask these things through Christ our Lord.
The sun will shine, and the dawn of eternal.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly, to complete what was begun in sacred mystery and powerfully accomplished for us your saving work through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feast through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. I see that we kind of connected. I was doing my stuff. You did your thing.
Yeah.
I put my stuff.
How are you?
Morning.
How are you?